Joining us now via Skype is Chris Stefanik. I'm a big fan of the confirmation program he authored called Chosen. And today, Chris joins us to talk about his book called I Am. Thanks so much for being with us, Chris.
Thank you for having me. Yeah, thanks for using Chosen, too.
Oh, really? It's just been a real blessing for me. Thanks.
Praise God.
But I do want to talk about I Am. You know, so we're in the Christmas season, the beginning of a new calendar year, new beginnings. Tell us about I Am.
The best thing you could do to start your year right is to make sure you talk to yourself right. I mean, so many people go through their lives thinking and not thinking about what they're thinking or why they're thinking it, specifically about themselves. You know, people label themselves in all the wrong ways. We get our labels and how we talk to ourselves, how we see ourselves from maybe bad experiences in life, from failures we experience, from abusive situations in our past or whatever it might be, but God's word tells us who we actually are. And the way we label ourselves, that conversation we're having in our head, we can't afford to get it wrong, because how we see ourselves determines how we act, which determines our whole lives. So this is making sure that at the foundation of your whole life, you got the right self-image, which comes from the word of God, who reveals who you really are, that you're precious, that you're worth dying for, that you're blessed, that you're chosen, that you could do all things to Christ who strengthens you. And that should affect how you carry yourself, how you see yourself, how you live.
Absolutely. You know, I think the website, Rewrite Your Name, is perfect, just perfect for new beginnings, and especially for that mental war of words that you were just referencing. Tell us how I Am helps us reshape that self-perception.
Yeah, we're usually passive recipients of the way we perceive ourselves. We don't even think we have any role to play in that head game. St. Paul tells us in 2 Corinthians, we take captive every thought and make it obedient to Christ. We take captive every thought and make it obedient to Christ. So the book is a series of short meditations to help you form the habit of contemplating his word, because his word doesn't only reveal who he is, but it reveals who we are, what we're worth, what our dignity is, that we're royalty in him. So it's the daily practice of meditating on his word and what he says about you as his beloved child, and learning how to speak that life into your own head.
Yeah.
How to breathe that life into yourself, how to look in the mirror and say the right things, to see the right things. So it's simple, short meditations organized around a busy life like yours and mine. That really is changing people's lives. I'm blown away by the feedback I'm getting from this.
That's great to hear, because there is so much negative talk. And, you know, Jesus came for us to live life abundantly and certainly to revel in his royalty.
Yes.
Now, we think of the new year as a time for resolutions, for, you know, kind of rerouting our lives. You know, how does I Am encourage the reader to live the Catholic faith boldly?
Yeah. Make your resolution seeing yourself, aligning how you see yourself with the word of God. Make that the resolution. Stop. I mean, you don't have to go into, you know, 2020 talking the same junk to yourself.
We've
never told people more frequently, love yourself, love yourself. I don't think we've ever had more self-loathing than we have now.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think you're right.
Right? And maybe that's because we have a secularized worldview that says, you know, you're a cosmic accident. You're a lump of cells that's achieved self-awareness. You'll become worm food, but believe in yourself.
Yeah.
What? We have the compelling reasons why you should believe in yourself. You know, that because you were created with a purpose by a God who loves you, thinks so much of you that he thinks you're worth dying for, destines you for eternal glory, breathes his life and power into you, has a purpose for you today. But I'll tell you, It is time that we, as people of God, start actually living like we believe that. Because we shouldn't look like everybody else.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. That's beautiful. Now, oddly enough, the website offers visitors the opportunity to receive a free chapter of I Am. How long does that offer continue, and how can people access it?
Oh, it's go to rewriteyourname.com. It's also, if you can't remember that, it's on my website, reallifecatholic.com. Click on the store. And that free chapter is always up there. And there's daily also memes you can download each day to reinforce the lessons you're learning from I Am. You know, I encourage practical things like people posting, you know, that name for themselves on social media, writing post-its around your house. I mean, we really have to start preaching to ourselves. So there's little helps in there to preach the truth to yourself. I don't think God gave us his word so we'd wait for Catholic TV to preach to us, right? It helps, right? The whole purpose of Catholic TV, Catholic radio, the stuff that I do, it's to help people start preaching to themselves. You know, so there's little helps on there to start doing that every day.
That's great. That affirmation and that power in Jesus Christ to be a powerful witness. Thanks so much for taking the time to be with us. We really appreciate it. Happy New Year. And I encourage everyone to visit rewriteyourname.com. Thanks so much, Chris.
Thank you. Been a blessing being with you.